Tracy here. Today I want to share with you a little tip that I came up with to use in my planner. So let me share it with you. And before I share it with you, I want to show you what I used. And I used these vertical badge holders. And what they are these clear pockets. And they have some holes in them. So they have this one slit hole. I'm assuming you can put a lanyard in there. And it has two holes over here. And I'm thinking they're for pins, like to put on your jackets. You can put your name tag, or I'm not sure. I'm assuming they're for name tags. But I picked them up quite a while ago because they were pretty cheap and I didn't know what to do with them then, but I found a use for them. So what I am using them for is to keep me on task for my cleaning chores. And I adapted the cleaning chores from Fly Lady. I used to follow her, many, many years ago. And I took some of the things that worked for me and I keep using them. I don't really follow her per se anymore, like her website, that's too confusing to me. It used to be so easy and now it's so confusing. So I don't really follow her website or anything, but like I said, I took her ideas and I adapted them to work for me. So every Monday, I do a cleaning of my home and I spend 15 minutes in each room and I clean and then I vacuum each room and dust each room and, you know, stuff like that. So what I did was I printed these up on my computer and then I just did a little stamping and I inked around the edges because, you know, you got to be a little creative. And then at the back, I just put some cardstock in here, or some pattern paper, I should say. And I did some stamping and I inked around the edges just so it looks pretty, so it's not just white. And also I did that for if I have a special task I want to do, I can write it on the back with a dry erase marker. And another thing I did was I used this ruler, or this today ruler. I used this to get the holes right, because like I had shared with you, it's hard to see, I know. There was that slot, and then they had two holes on either side. So I used this as a template, and I just used, I call it a paperboy's punch, because when I did the papers when I was a kid, that's how old the punch is. I've had it since I was like, I don't know, 8, 10, however old I was. But anyway, and it punched through this plastic really nicely. And then I cut a little slit up there so I could take it in and take it out. Because this one is going to be going for next week. Once I'm done these chores, I'll go for next week. And then another thing I adapted from Fly Lady is each room in your home has a zone and you rotate it each week. And you focus on that one room to detail clean, I guess. And so that's what I did with this one. I printed it off what pertains to my home, and this week is the bedroom. And then I did some more stamping, some more inking, and I added a different thing of pattern paper on here. And they just fit on here so nicely, and they're tiny, and they fit perfect, and they're for this week, so it's easy for me to, because I usually have this open, and it's just easy for me to look at it. Oh, this is what I need to do, even though I probably know how to do this, because I've been doing this for I don't know how long. And so I think that it's going to work well for me. I'm excited about it, can you tell? And I know when I first put this journal together, I think this is my third year with this journal, I did the same thing in the back here. I printed up the cleaning lists and stuff like that worked for my home, but I never seem to go back there. I don't know why. I just don't seem to go back there. I usually just keep it open to the day that I'm at. And what I did is I have this zipper pocket back here, and that's where I put all my stickers that I make for birthdays. I just put this on Avery labels, stamp them out, color them with my markers, and then fussy cut them out. But that's not what we're talking about. We're talking about these little beauties. And another thing I did was some weeks the room is more than one room. Like here there's the bathroom, but then there's more rooms besides the bathroom for this one. So I put an arrow to remind me to flip it over. And this one has the laundry room and also an office, which I really don't have an office, but just to keep my office stuff organized, like my bills and that. And so that's what I did there. I have it on the other side, some of them. Yeah, this one has it on the other side. This one all fits on one side. And I don't know, I think it's going to work great for me. I think it's because it's on that day, I don't have to flip to the back of the book. I know, eh? Like, it's so hard to flip to the back of the book. Like, talk about laziness or what. But, like I said, I like to keep everything, you know, on this day and I just leave it open on my dining room table or where my mail is, I just leave it open. And here is last week, or the week that we just passed. This one is has a little bit more stuff in there just to show you that I do write in it. It's just this one I haven't gotten around to doing that today. So I just wanted to share with you that these are a neat little idea, and you can put other things on here, obviously, besides your cleaning schedule. I don't know, your work schedule or things that your kids have to do, like every Wednesday if they have to go to skating and every Friday they go to hockey or whatever your children do. So I just wanted to share that with you because I thought that was a fun little idea that you might want to incorporate into your journal. So thank you everybody for watching, and I hope you all had a very creative day today. Bye now.